हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू स्टूडेंट्स? यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम इन दिस नेक्स्ट वीडियो. दिस इज द वीडियो, दिस इज द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द चैप्टर नंबर 3, रिप्रोडक्शन इन ह्यूमन बीइंग. सो ह्यूमन रिप्रोडक्शन वी विल डिस्कस इन दिस चैप्टर. दिस इज द फर्स्ट वीडियो. तो फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हियर, दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मेल एंड फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट्स. ओके, सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट. फर्स्ट आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू दैट डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एनी बॉडी ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म हैव टू टाइप ऑफ पार्ट्स, द वेजिटेटिव पार्ट एंड रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट. सो इफ वी एक्सेप्ट द रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट एंड ऑल द बॉडी पार्ट्स आर नोन एज द वेजिटेटिव पार्ट. आई ऑल्सो टोल्ड यू अर्लियर इन द वीडियोज. ओके, सो हियर फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट, देन आफ्टर फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट. मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट हैज टू टाइप ऑफ रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट, एसेसरी रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट एंड नेसेसरी रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट. व्हाट दीज आर डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एनी रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट्स और एनी रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन हैज टू टाइप ऑफ पार्ट्स, मीन्स एसेसरी पार्ट्स एंड नेसेसरी पार्ट. एसेसरी पार्ट्स आर दोज पार्ट ऑफ द दोज रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट विच डज नॉट डायरेक्टली पार्टिसिपेट इन द गैमेट फॉर्मेशन. सो दीज रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट आज नोन एज द एसेसरीज पार्ट. सो इन दीज एसेसरीज पार्ट कम्स व्हाट, द ग्लैंड्स एंड डक्ट्स. सो ग्लैंड्स एंड डक्ट्स आर द एसेसरी पार्ट्स ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, बट नेसेसरी पार्ट्स आर द पार्ट्स विच डायरेक्टली पार्टिसिपेट इन द गैमेट फॉर्मेशन. सो दीज पार्ट ऑफ मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम आर नोन एज द नेसेसरी पार्ट. ओके, व्हाट दीज आर, दीज आर द टेस्टीज. ओके, सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर लेट्स डिस्कस. फर्स्ट ड्रॉ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. सो लेट्स ड्रॉ इट. डियर स्टूडेंट, डू नो हियर दिस इज, सपोज दिस इज द यूरिनरी ब्लैडर यू आर लुकिंग हियर एंड दीज आर द यूरेटर्स. ओके, बिकॉज द वास्ट डिफरेंस ऑफ द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम इट हैंग्स ऑन द दीज यूरेटर्स. ओके, सो हियर लेट्स डिस्कस. So you are looking here, what I am drawing, these are the vas differences. Okay, so they join the urethra here. Okay, this is urinary bladder, I am drawing it. This is urinary bladder. Okay, so here this is urethra. Dear students, here this is urethra. So let's discuss here. These vast difference comes to join these are the testes. Okay, I am drawing here, these are the testes. So human male has one pair of testes. So this is the one testy, this is the left, and this one I am drawing here, this is left testes. Okay, so here we will discuss the detail of testes. Dear students, here each testes is covered by the a small covering known as the scrotum. This is scrotum. Okay, so the outermost covering of the testes, inside the testes are situated. Because testes are one pair of testes, so each testes is situated in the sac-like structure which is covered by the skin. This is known as the sac-like structure known as the scrotum. Okay, so this is scrotum. Inside the scrotum testes are situated. If we study the testes structure, so here each testis has testicular lobules. So here you are looking, these are the testicular lobules present inside it. Okay, so here you are looking, this is the coiled tube. In each lobule, this coiled tube is present. What is this coiled tube? This coiled tube is seminiferous tubule. Okay, then all seminiferous tubules comes outside from this testicular lobule and forms the network of ducts. Okay, so you are looking, this earlier network of the ducts is known as the rete testes. Okay, rete testes. But this earlier network form the small duct like structures. You are looking here, small duct like structures are present here. These are the bassa efferentia. These bassa efferentia comes out from the testes and form the coiled tube, which is present inside this structure. This is known as the epididymis. You are looking here, this is epididymis. Epididymis, okay. In this epididymis, the coiled structure is formed, the coiled tube. This is the vasa efferentia. These vasa efferentia collect here and coiled here. So in this, the coiled vasa efferentia are present here in epididymis. So in epididymis, these coiled tubes are present and these coiled tubes come outside from the epididymis. Then these are known as what? These are known as the bass difference. Okay, so bass difference, this is the broader tube. This bass difference goes upward and hang on the ureters. You are looking here, these are the ureters. So ureters hang on ureters. So here, dear friends, these vas deferens, when meet together or meet with urethra, before meeting point of the urethra, these are connected with these glands and these lobule like glands. These glands are known as what? Seminal vesicle. So these one pair of seminal vesicles are connected with vas deferens. After connecting seminal vesicles or duct of the seminal vesicle, this vas deferens gets converted into ejaculatory duct. Okay, so this is now known as the ejaculatory duct. This ejaculatory duct gets open into the urethra. So you are looking here, this is the urethra, this is urinary bladder. So urinary bladder gets open into the urethra at the meeting point of the urethra. Here a trigonal or the triangular gland is situated here, which covers outside the whole urethra at the meeting point of this ejaculatory duct. Okay, so you are looking here, this triangular gland, I am shading it. So this triangular gland is known as what? This is known as prostate gland. So this is the prostate gland. This is prostate gland. Okay, so just at the base of prostate gland, one pair of a small gland or lobule like glands are present here. These are known as Cooper's gland और बल्बो यूरेथ्रल ग्लैंड, बल्बो यूरेथ्रल ग्लैंड्स, गॉट इट? सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, बल्बो यूरेथ्रल ग्लैंड्स आर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. दैट इज वाई दिस इज द मेन इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, दैट विच टाइप ऑफ ग्लैंड सिमुलेट्स विद द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम और ग्लैंड्स विद द प्रेजेंट इन फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. सो दिस इज द बल्बो यूरेथ्रल ग्लैंड. ओके, नाउ दिस इज यू आर लुकिंग हियर, दिस इज द पोर्शन ऑफ यूरेथ्रा which again gets transformed into penis. Okay, so this structure is known as the penis. Penis, the uppermost region or the ending portion of the region or the topmost region of the penis is covered by the foreskin. So penis is the what? This is the tissue or the muscular structure. Muscles are formed, muscular tissues are present here. There is no bone. Muscles and the number of the blood vessels are present here. So here the inside the penis or at the opening of the penis, this is the opening. This is known as the urethral opening because urethra gets open into the penis, and this penis, through this penis, the urethral opening, it is the ending portion of this duct. This is known as the urethral opening. Got it? So this is the male reproductive system. Dear students, male reproductive system, we have drawn it. Now let's discuss what is the function, how it works, and where sperms are found or the female gamete are formed. So dear students, here in each testes, these are the testicular lobules. I told you earlier, testicular lobules. In testicular lobules, the coiled structure seminiferous tubules are present here. Seminiferous tubules. So in seminiferous tubule, dear students, in seminiferous tubule, if we cut the transverse section of the seminiferous tubule, so it will looks like it, because the side, seminiferous tubules of the side will look like this, and one seminiferous tubule, it has the complete section or transverse section, okay, like this. So the wall of seminiferous tubule, it has the number of germinal cells or germ cells. So germ cells are present here. So the layers of germ cell is known as the germinal epithelium. So this is known as germinal epithelium. So germinal epithelium has the cells which are known as the germ cells. Germ cells gets developed and undergoes the meiosis division and form the sperms. So dear students, sperms are formed here. Sperms move through the retinaces toward the vasa efferentia. Here vasa efferentia, afterward vasa efferentia sperms move toward the epididymis. Here in epididymis, sperms rest for some time or gets mature here. Okay, sperms after formation stored here and mature. Okay, after maturation or at the time of coitus, the sperms from epididymis releases through the vas deferens. So you are looking, this is vas deferens, one pair of vas deferens are present. So vas deferens, through the vas deferens, these sperms are in the form of cells. You are looking here just like this cell. So these sperms, when reach toward the ejaculatory duct, then the seminal fluid means the slimy or the nutritious fluid which is secreted by the seminal vesicle. So the fluid secreted by seminal vesicle is known as the seminal fluid. So seminal fluid is secreted with sperms in ejaculatory duct. So now sperms get mixed in the solution or fluidy, then forms the semen. So semen is formed after the secretion of seminal vesicle. Okay, prostate glands also make some content of the semen. So semen is the mixture of sperm and nutritious fluid which is secreted by the prostate gland as well as seminal vesicle. Okay, now bulbo urethral gland, before the ejaculation, because when the semen ejaculate in urethra, so before the ejaculation means releasing out of the semen, बिफोर द एजेकुलेशन बल्बो यूरेथ्रल ग्लैंड सिक्रेट व्हाट? बल्बो यूरेथ्रल ग्लैंड सिक्रेट सम स्लाइमी सबस्टेंस विच इज बेसिक इन नेचर बिकॉज दिस इज द यूरेथ्रा एंड यूरेथ्रा ऑल्सो यूटिलाइज फॉर द यूरिन सिक्रीशन दैट इज बाई द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम इज नोन एज द यूरिनोजेनाइटल सिस्टम. सो वी कैन से दिस मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द यूरिनोजेनाइटल सिस्टम. यूरिनोजेनाइटल सिस्टम ओके बिकॉज यूरिन सिक्रीशन ऑल्सो टेक्स प्लेस थ्रू दिस यूरेथ्रा. सो दैट इज बाई आफ्टर यूरिन सिक्रीशन यूरिन इज द एसिडिक इन नेचर दैट इज बाई द कॉपर्स ग्लैंड सिक्रीट सम स्लाइमी सबस्टेंस और द फ्लूडी सबस्टेंस विच मेक्स द पैसेज ऑफ यूरेथ्रा बेसिक इन नेचर और सलाइन इन नेचर. दैट इज बाई स्पर्म आर सिक्रेटेड इन द सीमेन थ्रू द एजेकुलेटरी डक्ट इन द यूरेथ्रा आर नॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड इन एसिडिक मीडियम. गॉट इट? सो दिस इज द पैसेज एंड दिस इज द ओवरऑल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम एंड नेसेसरी पार्ट. सो दिस इज द टेस्टिस, दिस इज नेसेसरी पार्ट, बट ऑल दीज डक्ट्स लाइक रेटेड टेस्टिस, वासा एफरेंसिया, वास डिफरेंस एंड सेमिनल वेसिकल, प्रोस्टेट ग्लैंड, कॉपर्स ग्लैंड, इजेकुलेटरी डक्ट्स, दीज ऑल आर द एसेसरी पार्ट और एसेसरी रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट ऑफ द मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई थिंक यू आर गेटिंग इट, इट इज क्लियर टू यू. नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम ओके और एसेसरी फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट. एंड ओवरी आर द मेन और नेसेसरी रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट. सो नेसेसरी रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट आर one pair of ovary are found in human female. So let's draw the structure of female reproductive system. So dear students, you are looking here. This is the diagram of female reproductive system. So here you are looking that in female reproductive system, there are one pair of ovaries present. So you are looking here. These are the ovaries. Okay. This ovary is connected with the tube. This tube is known as the fallopian tube. Fallopian tube, and it is also known as the oviduct. Oviduct, got it? This oviduct or fallopian tube has three part. This is the filamentous structure. You know, this is the finger-like projection are presenting here. So this structure is known as the infundibulum. Infundibulum. This infundibulum. Elongates or open into the bending part of oviduct. This oviduct bending part is known as the what? Ampulla. Ampulla. And it gets open the straight part. This straight part is known as the isthmus. Isthmus. सो दिस इज द इस्थमस. ओके, सो वन ओविडक्ट और फेलोपियन ट्यूब हैज थ्री पार्ट, इनफंडिबुलम, दिस इज एम्पुला एंड इस्थमस. गॉट इट? नाउ हियर, जस्ट लाइक हियर, दिस फेलोपियन ट्यूब ऑल्सो इज डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट. नाउ दिस फेलोपियन ट्यूब गेट्स ओपन इंटू द यूटेरस. दिस इज द कैविटी लाइक स्ट्रक्चर यू आर लुकिंग हियर, दिस इज यूटेरस. सो दिस इज यूटेरस यू आर लुकिंग हियर. यूटेरस, the uterine wall, the wall of uterus is divided into three part. The outermost layer of the uterus is perimetrium and the middle layer. So just like I am drawing here, this one is the middle layer of uterus. You are looking here, this middle layer of uterus is known as the myometrium. And next one or inner one is known as the endometrium. Got it? So here endometrium, perimetrium and myometrium, these are three layer of uterus. So this uterus gets narrow toward the lower side and forms the canal like structure. So just a smaller canal you are looking here. This is the smaller canal. This smaller canal is known as what? Cervix, or we can say it cervical canal. This cervical canal gets open into the another tube like structure. This is known as the vagina. Okay, and now vagina gets open into vaginal opening. Got it? So this is overall structure of the female reproductive system. Students, let's discuss how it works and how these structures gets participate into the gamete formation. The main gamete formation occurs in the ovary, because in the ovary, the wall of ovary, just like the wall of seminiferous tubule, it also has the germinal epithelium. So this is germinal epithelium. So this is germinal epithelium. Okay, you are looking here. Germinal epithelium has the germ cells. These germ cells undergo the meiosis division and form the what? Egg, or it is also known as the ovum. So ovum gets released from here. This is infundibulum. This tube like structure of fallopian tube has the flagella like structure throughout the whole fallopian tube. So when egg is released from this ovary here, this egg is non-motile, but with the help of flagella it moves toward the uterus. Got it? So both the ovaries are not functional at same time. Dear students, at one time only one ovary is functional. So in 1 month one ovary is functional, and next month next ovary is functional. So this ovary gets functional and secretes some hormone. These hormones are known as what? Female hormone, or estrogen and progesterone. Okay, so these hormones play very important role in pregnancy as well and in the secondary sexual character development in human female. So this is the human female reproductive system. Egg is released from here, goes into the fallopian tube, and with the help of fallopian tube it reaches toward the uterus. It gets fertilized. If fertilization takes place, the fertilization takes place at the junction of what? Ampulla and isthmus. So ampulla and isthmus, they get meet together from here. They meet together here. So the meeting point of ampulla and isthmus, this egg gets fertilized. If egg gets fertilized, then there is some changes occur in endometrium. Endometrium gets developed more and more. Okay, and it provide the nutrition to this fertilized egg, which is getting developed into the embryo. Okay, so this endometrium, it is the capacity to divide more and more and proliferate more and more. If fertilization does not take, so this endometrium, because ovary changes the hormonal secretion, then this endometrium gets rid of, because this proliferated endometrium, it is degraded and it comes outside with the blood. So this is known as the menstrual fluid at each menstrual cycle. Dear students, So this is menstruation occurs every month due to the changes of hormones inside the ovary. Okay, if fertilization does not take place, fertilization takes place, endometrium gets persist and it provide the place and it facilitate the development of embryo of this fertilized egg. Okay, so students, I think this is enough. One more thing I am telling you, that endometrium, it is very important role of myometrium, because at the time of delivery, when this embryo gets developed and forms baby inside the mother womb, this uterus, in this uterus, then myometrium has the contraction and relaxation due to the presence of muscles. So these muscles are very stronger muscles. They contract and relax very frequently, and contraction of these muscles is very strong. That is why the baby developed inside the uterus, it comes outside from the female body. This process is known as the parturition, and what this known as the parturition and delivery of the baby, or birth of the baby. Okay, so perimetrium, it is the outermost covering, it covers the endometrium, and myometrium, it is protective in nature. Got it? So these male and female reproductive system we have discussed. In our next video, we will discuss about the gametogenesis, spermatogenesis, as well as oogenesis. So dear students, thanks for watching this video. If you are liking the video, you should share among your friend, and also subscribe this YouTube channel. Thank you.